intestinal obstruction. In this coming few minutes, we will start our section by classifying different types of intestinal obstruction, then duodenal atresia, malrotation, intussusception, volvulus, ileus, adhesion and band formation, along with some different MCQ points which is important regarding intestinal obstruction. We will start from the general introduction about this all the disease. First of all, studying about the classification, there are different types of classification given to the intestinal obstruction. It can be according to the small bowel obstruction or large bowel obstruction. And the important clinical presentation of small bowel obstruction is they present with vomiting, whereas the large bowel obstruction, they will present with the distension of the abdomen. The other classification can be simple or strangulated. Simple ka matlab hota hai when there is no vascular compromise due to obstruction, whereas strangulated mein kya ho gaya, due to the obstruction the vascular supply to the gut will be diminished or obstructed, as a result it will go under ischemia. So this can be either simple or strangulated type related to the vascular compromise. Then the obstruction can either be complete obstruction or partial obstruction. Partial or complete obstruction means, suppose that this is the lumen and the lumen is partially obstructed, then this is partial type, whereas if the complete obstruction is present, then it will be called as complete obstruction. Then the other will be according to the cause behind the obstruction. Suppose that the cause is inside the lumen, that will be called as intraluminal type of obstruction. This is the most important type of classification in which you have to remember some of the causes, means intraluminal. What are the intraluminal cause for obstruction? Something there can be fecolith, gallstone, bezoar's formation. Bezoar ka matlab hota hai when the fecus material get incorporated with indigestible substance like hairs, then it will make a bolus which is not digestible and will block the intestine. That is called as bezoar's. It can be fecolith, gallstone, infection, so these are tumors, some of the intraluminal cause of the intestinal obstruction. Then intramural means something in the wall of the intestine, gut ke wall mein agar ho jaye, that will be called as intramural, which is which can be due to tumor in the wall, inflammatory stricture ho sakta hai, and inflammatory other disease like Crohn's disease or diverticulitis. Crohn's disease or diverticulitis can be there. Extramural mein some of the examples should be remembered as it can be hernia, adhesion band, volvulus, hernia, adhesion, and then volvulus. Volvulus is simply twisting of the gut, usually seen in the sigmoid colon, and then it can also be some of the space occupying lesion which can compress the gut. Space occupying lesion which can compress the gut. So this was the different mode of classifying the intestinal obstruction, and usually, as I said earlier, they will present with pain and vomiting if it is small bowel, and distension and rectal bleeding may be present during large bowel obstruction. So this is the general classification, and according to the cause we need to treat this patient. Now we will go to the disease portion. You can see that we classified in different method, that can be short bowel, large bowel, simple or strangulated according to the vascular compromise, then complete or partial, then we divided according to the wall of the got involved. Starting from the all the disease, we will just look a general introduction about all the disease. Look, duodenal atresia, it is the most common type of atresia in the intestine. Okay, and it is usually always associated with, not always, but the most common association in the GIT in the Down's patient is the duodenal atresia. And as the name suggests, there is atresia, means there is a stenosis of the duodenal part. As a result, there will be obstruction in the intestine. Okay, and this is the just a stenosis of the duodenal part, which is usually associated with the Down syndrome. And the other important question usually asked in the duodenal atresia is the appearance in the x-ray. During abdominal x-ray will show you double bubble sign. Okay, then the malrotation. Malrotation is simply during the development of the intestine, the intestine have to undergo two types of rotation. That is, initially it has clockwise 90 degree clockwise rotation, and then it has to go 270 degree anti-clockwise rotation. So this degree of rotation should be exactly similar in all the person. But if the rotation in the intestine in any person undergoes abnormal, then that will be called as malrotation, means interference in the process of the normal rotation of the midgut. Usually the malrotation is seen in the midgut portion. So midgut ka rotation agar abnormal ho gaya, so that will be called as malrotation. Abnormal rotation in the midgut will be, and it will result in abnormal fixation of mesenteric part, means midgut along with the mesenteric fixation is abnormal. Mesenteric fixation. Okay, then this will also result in the malrotation. And the next is the intussusception. In intussusception, there is suppose that this is the intestine, this is the intestine, then what happens, the distal part, this is the process of invagination of the intestinal segment. Okay, in which the adjoining intestinal lumen potentially result in the look, this is the intussusception, means the distal part goes inside the proximal intestinal lumen. That is called as, usually seen in the children. And in the definition of the intussusception will be, it is the process of invagination of the intestinal segment into the adjoining intestinal lumen. Okay, so we can remember it like this. Suppose that this is the gut, then what happens, the lumen of the gut goes inside this and then again comes out. So if you remember this picture, then easily you can remember, this is the proximal part and this is the distal part. And intussusception is usually seen in the ileocolic junction, in which it can also be seen in the colonocolic, means colon along with colon, and maybe this is the ileum and this is the colon. Okay, intussusception was the invagination of the intestinal segment inside the intussusceptum. And volvulus is the simply twisting of the intestinal gut. Twisting, and usually this is seen in what did we saw here? Intussusception is seen in ileocolic region, or it can be colonocolic, whereas the volvulus is present in the sigmoid colon is the most common site for the volvulus formation. And the other site, it can be cecum or सिग्मोइड के बाद में इट कैन ऑल्सो बी सीन इन द सीकम. इट इज सिंपली द ट्विस्टिंग ऑफ द गॉट वेर एज नाउ कमिंग टू द इलियस और द स्यूडो ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन. इन क्लासिफिकेशन वी मिस्ड वन क्लासिफिकेशन दैट इज डायनामिक एंड ए डायनामिक. Dynamic and adynamic. This is simply when, suppose that this is the gut and gut has got peristaltic movement. If the peristaltic movement is normal, so even though there is obstruction in the gut, suppose that here is obstruction, then what will the peristaltic movement try to do? It will try to expel the bolus of the food substance by increasing its peristaltic movement and try to escape this obstruction. Okay, if the peristaltic movement is intact, then we will call it as dynamic. And if the peristaltic movement is abnormal, as in case of the ileus, then the peristaltic movement is not sufficient or it is not intact, then due to the abnormal, even though there is no any obstruction, due to this absence peristaltic movement, the bolus of the food cannot go in the distal part. Okay. So this is the classification according to the presence or absence of the peristaltic movement. So in ileus there is absence of peristaltic movement, aortic movement, and it usually results from metabolic or inflammatory or infection of the gut region, or it can also be due to the post surgical. The causes can be either surgical, inflammatory, metabolic abnormality, like it can be due to hypokalemia, hypomagnesemia, ketoacidosis, infection and inflammation. Some of the drug like opioid and antipsychotic can also cause ileus. So this is a dynamic type of intestinal obstruction. Then at last, adhesion and band. This is the formation of the stricture or band formation, which will be result of the fibrosis in the intestinal lumen. Fibrosis, due to the fibrosis there will be obstruction. As a result, there will be a stenosis in the region of the fibrosed part and will cause a formation of adhesion and band. Adhesion का मतलब हुआ due to, suppose that the inflammatory lumen का जो wall होता है, the wall of the inflammatory lumen will undergo inflammation. Then what will be? This will be diseased part, and if it will touch with underlying any substance or any other part of the intestine, or it may even touch with the opposite, means other lumen, so there will be adhesion of both the part and result in obstruction. Okay. And this is usually seen after infection or during surgery. It can also be due to ischemia, infection, inflammation, post surgery. It can be due to any radiation or TB malignancy, tuberculosis malignancy may be hota hai. And this is about the adhesion. Now this was just about the introduction. We should look some of the specific point in duodenal atresia. This is all that one should know, and usually it is associated with the Down syndrome. Okay, but the double bubble sign is a very important double bubble sign seen in the x-ray, is very important in case of duodenal atresia. Then the mal rotation, as I said earlier, that this is abnormal rotation of the midgut along with mesenteric fixation is also abnormal. Usually how do they present? Because it involves the midgut, there will be acute or recurrent intestinal obstruction. Clinical feature will be of obstruction, and obstruction mein kaise aate hain, so there can be some of the obstruction ka feature, and otherwise due to this obstruction they may also undergo strangulation. Strangulation matlab ki demyelinized ischemia or demyelinized vascular compromise in the gut part, which will result in ischemia, and the feature will be like septicemia shock or dark sputum and very severe pain, edema, erythema. So we can remember the clinical feature by remembering that their presentation is usually according to the obstruction, and some of the complication can be like strangulation, or it may also form peritonitis, perforation of the gut can also be seen. Okay, and for the investigation we will send for any intestinal obstruction we will send what are the investigation that we can send. We will send abdominal x-ray, then endoscopy, USG of abdomen. Endoscopy can be either according to the site of the obstruction, it can be upper GI or lower GI, then the USG of abdomen, and if it is the case of the tumor we should also go for biopsy, and obviously the other routine examination will involve the blood and urine and stool examination. So these are some of the important investigation which we will repeat in all the diseases. So under malrotation also we will send all these features, but the specific sign which is seen in the there is no such a specific or sign in related to the malrotation. So the treatment modality, first of all we need to treat this complication. If the patient had presented with this complication, we need to resuscitate and treat accordingly, maintain airway breathing circulation, and at last for the malrotation we have to perform a surgery called as LAD operation. LAD operation is done. Okay, so this is the treatment. Now the intussusception, it is the intestinal obstruction in which the lumen of the intestine have gone inside the other part of the lumen, and usually seen in case of ileocolic and colonocolic, as I said earlier. Then the other point related to the intussusception is the cause behind the intussusception. These causes are very specific and very different. Okay, so the causes, if the patient is less than 3 years, then usually the cause is lymphoid hyperplasia or Meckel's diverticulum. This may result, usually the intussusception is post to any other obstruction. Okay, this usually results after the obstruction, means suppose that there is some other cause of obstruction present in the intestinal lumen, that will result in the intussusception, and that sort of obstruction can be due to polyp, it can be due to Meckel's diverticulum. Meckel's diverticulum is the persistence of the vitelo-intestinal duct, also called as omphalomesenteric duct, which is responsible for communicating between the yolk sac and the midgut of the child. And if it persists for more than 6 weeks, then that is called as Meckel's, that will form a diverticulum called as Meckel's diverticulum. So the causes can be polyp, Meckel's diverticulum, or lymph node enlargement, usually in the Peyer's patch. Okay, so the other causes can be any respiratory infection, means child agar hai, this is usually in case of less than 3 year child. If the child is more than 3 year, then it usually comes post to respiratory tract infection, RTI ke baad mein hota hai. There can be some sort of blood abnormality like Henoch-Schönlein purpura, Henoch-Schönlein purpura ka bhi feature ho sakta hai. If the patient is adult, then usually they present with post to polyp tumor, means the key word in this intussusception is, usually the intussusception is post to any other cause of intestinal obstruction, and this can also be due to Meckel's diverticulum in the adult. So how do they present? Usually they present with the pain, and blood mucus is usually passed from the stool, which resemble red currant jelly. The presentation will be pain, bloody blood plus mucus mixed stool, and which is usually resembles in red current. And for examination, the hypochondrium will be sausage shape, sources shape hypochondrium. This is important point. Sources shape hypochondrium. Right hypochondrium will be there, and they may also present with the some of the complication, as we saw in the malrotation, that it can also present with strangulation, perforation, and peritonitis. Okay, so this is applicable in intussusception also. Then the investigation, as I said earlier, our option will be x-ray and all these investigation. Then what will be you see, usually the abdominal x-ray shows absence of air in the right side of the bowel, which is the feature of abdominal x-ray. Mein kya dikhta hai? Absence of air bubble in the right side, which is usually present. Okay, then ultrasound, all USG will show you that there is target shaped mass, and air contrast or air enema will show you coiled spring appearance of the air enema, coiled spring mass. This is due to the invagination of the intestinal segment. Okay, then what will you do in as a treatment modality? First of all, supportive treatment for the resuscitation if the patient has presented with the complication of the intussusception. After resuscitation, and therapeutic enema to reduce the invaginated segment. Means first of all, you should look for the complication of these condition. If the complication are managed after resuscitation, then we will go for the surgical treatment. Usually the we will look for the viability of the usually we will look for viability of this segment. If it is viable, we will like to reduce the bowel segment, and if it is non-viable, then rejection and anastomosis. It is very easy, means viability. If present, then obviously we will just reduce that segment, and we will look for the cause behind the intussusception and treat accordingly. Okay, and if the viability is absent, then we have to reject that segment, and then anastomosis should be done. So, as I said earlier, that the cause is usually present in the ileocecal or colonocolic. So, this is all about the intussusception. Then, the volvulus. Volvulus is the twisting or rotation of the gut part. Okay. Volvulus twisting, it was twisting and present in the sigmoid colon. Then, there can also be cecal volvulus, means cecum can also be involved in case of volvulus. What will be the presentation of the cecum? This is the second most common site. The first is the sigmoid, and usually the sigmoid volvulus is associated with different types of syndrome or other disease. This sigmoid is associated with CHAMP, CHAMP. Okay, C is for the Chagas disease, H is the hypothyroidism, and then anticholinergic drug, mentally retarded individual or multiple sclerosis, and P is for the Parkinsonism disease. So volvulus is usually associated with different types of diseases. Okay, and the other point related to the cecum volvulus is the on x-ray they will show you round glass shadow. Okay, on x-ray the cecal volvulus shows round glass appearance, and it can be either acute or recurrent type. There are two types of volvulus, can be acute or recurrent. And the clinical feature will be obviously similar to the any intestinal obstruction according to the sites. As we know that it is large bowel obstruction, then they will present with constipation, abdominal distension, and vomiting at last, And at last, the late presentation can also be vomiting and dehydration. And as a complication, there may be peritonitis, as we are looking in all the obstructive cases. For investigation, when we will send plain X-ray, abdominal X-ray, abdominal X-ray will show you two signs that is very important. That is omega sign, and the other is the coffee bean sign. Coffee bean sign. And in contrast enema, there will be bald beak appearance. Usually this bald beak sign is also seen in case of ecclesia cardia, but that was barium swallow. But now we are doing barium enema. Barium enema will show you bald beak appearance. Bald beak appearance. And for the treatment modality, again, after the resuscitation and general management, according to if the patient have undergone any complication, means after stabilization of the patient, we have to give antibiotic, and laparotomy should be done with the repair of the sigmoid part, okay? Laparoscopic repair is done. Repair means simply we will untwist the part, and if it has undergone gangrenous or strangulation, then we will reject that part. Again, same as the intussusception, we will look the viability. If it is viable, then we will just reduce, means we will just untwist the part, and then if it has strangulated, then we will reject and anastomose the part. Then the last component is the ileus. Ileus is the adynamic or absence of the peristaltic movement in the GIT, okay? Ileus is the absence of peristaltic movement, and that can be due to post-surgery. It can be due to inflammation or infection of the gut wall. It can be due to the metabolic disturbances like decrease in the potassium, calcium and magnesium, okay? And some of the drugs like opioid can also cause ileus. And a very important syndrome, that is Ogilvie syndrome. Ogilvie's syndrome, which is colonic pseudo obstruction associated with long term debility, chronic disease, immobility and polypharmacy. This is also associated with ileus. Ileus is also called as pseudo obstruction because there is no any obstructive cause. It is due to the absence of the peristaltic movement. So this is also called as pseudo ileus. You should also know this. And then for the history, they will usually from the history, means for the approach, usually we will start from the history, and under history they will say that recently they have undergone any surgery, and there may be open bowel surgery or constipation history, and later on they can present with pain and maybe some obstructive disease symptom. Examination may or may not show the distension, and there may be bowel sound will be absent because of the absence of peristaltic movement. There may be tenderness and fecal impaction on the rectal examination, and we will again send the blood and X-ray abdomen for investigation, and more than 12 centimeter increase in the cecal diameter increases the risk of perforation. You should also remember that cecal diameter should not increase more than 12 centimeter because after 12 centimeter there will be very much risk of perforation. And for the treatment, we will maintain this patient on nil peroral and then resuscitate, and we will find the resuscitation, airway, breathing, circulation, and after the patient is stabilized, we will look for the cause behind the ileus, means which of these causes present, and if it is electrolyte, then we will maintain the electrolyte balance, and avoidance of the drug, if any drug is caused, then some of the medical treatment includes antibiotic for the infection, and if there is no mechanical obstruction, some of the prokinetic agent like metoclopramide can be given, or domperidol. ओके, मीटोक्लोप्रोमाइड, डोमपेरिडोन एंड आईवी नियोस्टिग्मिन कैन बी गिवन इन एक्यूट कोलोनिक स्यूडो ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन विथ क्लोज मॉनिटरिंग बिकॉज इट हैज़ रिस्क ऑफ आईवी नियोस्टिग्मिन बिकॉज इट हैज़ रिस्क ऑफ ब्रेडिकार्डिया, ब्रोंकोस्पाज्म एंड हाइपोटेंशन. ओके, एंड सम ऑफ द सर्जिकल इंडिकेशन विल बी ओनली व्हेन इमिनेंट और रियलाइज परफोरेशन इज प्रेजेंट. सो वी विल डिकम्प्रेस एंड स्टोमा फॉर्मेशन इफ द देर इज परफोरेशन स्टोमा फॉर्मेशन और इफ कॉम्प्लिकेशन एग्जिस्ट इन लाइक सेगमेंटल और सब टोटल कोलोनिक रिजेक्शन. So we will reject that part and then usually in the region of iliorectal and then ilio and rectum is directly anastomosed. Subtotal colonic excision kar sakte hain isme in pseudo obstruction. And at last we should also know that due to some cause there may be adhesion of the intestinal lumen and cause obstruction, and the usual causes behind this adhesion will be like infection, surgery, ischemia of the bowel, and there can be tuberculosis and tuberculosis or any surgery. Okay, and the treatment modality will be adhenolysis will be done, means dissolution of the adhesion, and laparoscopic surgery can also be performed. Either we can go for laparoscopic or some adhenolysis. Okay, so this is the all about the intestinal obstruction. Thank you.